Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Raid Shadow Legends on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Raid Shadow Legends and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5. Which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Raid Shadow Legends. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to start we have to open our favorite internet browser. We selected the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to the next URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you can discover on the screen of the PC. There is no need to type anything, because there's a clickable link in the video description and as well in the first pinned comment. We ended up here on our own website of Usitility, where we have a precise information on the best way to download and install Raid Shadow Legends on PC. We search down a tad and simply click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we arrive here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Raid Shadow Legends on the PC. As you can discover here, we access a number of pros of running this emulator. So we will start downloading the Raid Shadow Legends by clicking on the button play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green color. We then click on the button. Of course, the download action takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the installer, okay, so we need to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I minimize the browser to start to see the installer better. The installation software is very simple. It is made up of two options, install and setup path. I am going to show you what setup path truly does. We simply click on it. And so we see that we display here the path where the emulator will be installed. If we choose to vary this folder, we are required to click on the browse option, and we opt for another directory and set up the emulator precisely where we would like. I am going to set it by default. I click on back. Therefore I click on install. Fantastic. The installation commences and it will proceed with the download of those MB that happens to be visible on the computer screen. When you save it on your machine, it could possibly be a bit more or less MB. The download speed may go at a higher speed or slower, based on your internet and depending on the velocity of the emulator web servers. Right now they are running incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this time, the emulator has been started instantly. As you can see now, down here, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right and when it attains the finish, the emulator is started for the first time. The fact is that the emulator has already been started, here it is for the first time. Before we keep going, as you can see, it created two icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks software icon is going to be the only one we are concerned about. Whenever we need to operate Raid Shadow Legends on the laptop or computer, we double-click on that icon and as a result launch the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let me do the next phase, that is a must, and that is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we'll click on Play Store. As you understand, the Google Play is launched. In this case we need to sign in. Presently when we're there, we must do this following step that is definitely absolutely mandatory. So we mouse click on Sign In. At present it says, Checking Info. It might from time to time get stuck in Checking Info, and it isn't going to advance. In this case, you can attempt to log in and after a few hours and it will quite likely be solved. At present we are going to type our email and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email address as well as its associated password. For example, you make use of the same email you use at the moment in your own YouTube account. Therefore I am going to submit my data and I will come back when I have done it. Voila, data typed. This is Google welcoming us and offering us the twos. We should say yes to them all by clicking, I agree. Then, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You could leave it checked, it's going to make a backup of your data on that device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you can utilize that feature if you want. We just click on accept. Google Play, formerly Android Market, is launched without need to open it manually and instantly. To install the game, we have got to browse the emulator desktop for Android by simply clicking on this app icon marked green colored. At this point that we are on the desktop of that emulator, we see that we have right here the install app option. We then click on the button. On this page we have the Android game. Why don't we click here on the install link that I am just presenting now in green color. This action will start the software setup. At this point it will download and install the game app. It can take a bit of time or it could also be very fast. It again all is going to depend on the connection to the web. It has already ended installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by clicking on the following button that I am highlighting in green, so that you can start Raid Shadow Legends for the very first time. You are already on the emulator desktop, then we're going to click on that brand new Raid Shadow Legends software icon which was created. Your game is started for the first time on your machine. There we have it, I could press anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. In addition, if you enter the promo code DKRISES, you will get the following free items: 50 XP Brew Force, 15 Force Potion High, 10 Arcane Potion High, 5 Arcane Potion Mid and 500 Kelvin Silver. You can use this promo code from 1st of September until October 18th. And you can use it once. I have to comment on the sound level of the emulator. It is here. We have got the icon of higher volume as well as the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't depend on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And also to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we could turn on the big screen, for which we have two choices. This one is the very first one, we just click on this icon which I am indeed designating in green color. Thus the screen is maximized, enjoying one border at the top, one on the right side and the last one at the bottom. In case that we want to play the video game in full screen, we hit this particular application icon. And we might without a doubt be enjoying the game in full screen setting. To quit the complete screen functionality, press the F11 key. And we might just be in normal screen setting. At this point, I am going to explain you the computer keyboard mapping which is quite helpful. That step we will be ready to use the game application much more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this software icon. It's now time to complete the required configurations. I am going to put the standard settings, though if you desire to improve it, you may very well do it now with no problem. As you can observe, the emulator is completely in our own language. In some cases it happens that the emulator is started in the improper language, such as, in Mandarin. And so to set it in the appropriate language we go here to the cogwheel. And thus here throughout additional settings, we click on the language drop down. We should go for the language we need, German, Chinese, and so forth. Once the language is determined, we should save, the emulator will reboot, and the game, next time we launch it, would also be in the opted for language. Presently, there is another point that we will need to take into account, and it is that we will get a message from Google Mail telling you that a different device has been connected with our Google account. It will definitely question us if we're the individuals who have connected that device. Yup, we shouldn't worry, because the emulator is simulating an Android electronic device. And in order to see which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we come here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Be sure you go here to the model selection. And right here we see that the emulator is emulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for my training. I hope you liked it, specifically that everyone thought it was interesting. If so, bring it a good thumb up, subscribe to our channel, and if you have feedback, questions or suggestions, put them in the comment box below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams every now and then, you get it down below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click any of the video tutorials which are usually appearing on the list of videos to watch and let's have fun again in the upcoming online videos. Bye.